You're watching the mailbox. I'm Yusuf Estes. We've got questions coming in here on the mailbox. Here's, okay, and then another one just came in. Okay, it says, how can I tell the people at my school about Islam? And my English is not so good. Okay, first of all, I don't know where you are when you're asking a question, so this means you need to go to your local imam, talk to somebody that you trust that knows Islam, and find out what the rules are there. Because, for instance, if you're in some countries, if you might be in America, United States, and you want to start talking about Islam at your school, it's okay when you're on a break, in your lunchroom, recess, and some of the other places. But when there's a class in progress, the teachers and the students are not supposed to be talking about religion. They will say that you didn't come here to learn about religion. You are here to learn about mathematics, history, reading and writing, spelling, and some of the other topics. So they're going to say that this is not your purpose to be here. Now, if you're in a religion course, then obviously you might like to talk about what Islam says on some of the issues. But what your question was, Ned, about that, you were asking me how you can talk about it, but your English isn't so good. I recommend to be very careful about two things. First of all, you need to understand what Islam really does teach on a lot of issues. That's why you watch programs like this. The second thing that I remind us about is to know how to present the material. Because it's not just about knowing the English language, it's also knowing how to say things in a way that'll be properly understood by the one you're talking to. You want to be very careful about this because you might say something away that will mix them up. One example is we talk about a tawheed, which is monotheism, worshiping only one God, especially never asking from the creation. We don't pray to a rock, a stick, a stone, or a bone. We pray to Allah. Oh, Allah, give me this. Allah, give me that. Allah, thank you, and so on. So when somebody is giving you the explanation about that, you're listening, you're going, that makes sense. Okay, I want to be a Muslim. But his English is weak, and he's saying, yes, you do shahada. Okay, what's shahada? And you say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu Muhammad Rasulullah, alhamdulillah, you come to Islam, new Muslim. And the first thing he said, oh, you're new Muslim now. So it means Allah, he accept your prayer. So brother, pray to me. Now right away the person goes, what? You just told me only to pray to Allah. You tell me to pray to you. Well, what happened? The person speaking missed one of the nuances of English. We don't say pray to me. We say pray for me. So something as simple as that could really confuse somebody. Here's a website for you to check out so that you can know more about how to find these answers. It's called whatsislam.com. And you'll find it and other links on our main site at the Islam Mailbox. But for sure, I want you to listen carefully. You must understand Islam yourself and how to present it in the language, such as English, so that you don't confuse yourself and other people when you're trying to talk about it. We'll help you as much as we can. Come to our website. It's called Islam Mailbox. com, and put your questions in there, and we can send you a full set of answers along with references where you can find it on our other internet websites. And I'm being told now that we've just run out of time for this episode, so go to our website, www.islammailbox.com. Until the next time, this is Yusuf Estes wishing you peace. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.